Hi, Tom Cole for the Steve Taylor Community Connection. It's certainly an honor and privilege to welcome in a very talented young lady, Karla Batt from the American Cancer Society. Karla, thank you so much for being here today. We're talking about the Real Men Wear Pink campaign, and kind of take us a little bit inside that, Karla. Give us some of the X and O's of that.
Okay, so the Real Men Wear Pink of Northwest Ohio, we nominate, our candidates are nominated, and we have a campaign that each candidate raises $2,500 to support breast cancer research programs and services. And the reason why we target the men is because oftentimes there's women in their lives that are affected by breast cancer or have a diagnosis of breast cancer,
yes,
and they don't know what to do for them. So it's their way of giving back and supporting those who've been affected by breast cancer.
Karla, how did you get, you know, there's always a story behind the story of how a very talented person like you would get involved with a great organization like the American Cancer Society. What's your backstory?
Well, personally, I'm a two-time cancer survivor, and breast cancer was one of them. My mom's a breast cancer survivor, and really, my platform is early detection because so many people survive cancer. I have people coming to me all the time and saying, you know, there's all this money being raised. How come there's no cure yet? Well, I've been cured twice.
Yes.
And my platform, like I said, is early detection. So not only raising the funds for research, which we don't find cures without research,
right,
but also the educational piece is very personally important to me because I feel like I'm here today because I had that mammogram and I did start young and I did have that conversation with my primary care doctor to, you know, get diagnosed at an early stage.
You know, Karla, that's such a, the message you just delivered to me is so poignant and so important because still yet today, when people hear, and you know where I'm going with this, when people hear the words, you know, you've got cancer, immediately many people, you know, shut down and they think, that's it, I'm done, and they start that process of, I'm not gonna be here for long. And it's so not true today. You're a two-time survivor of cancer. You look magnificent. You're a strong woman, obviously. That I know that's not easy. My mom went through a cancer scenario, so I know a little bit about how that goes. And you're an inspiration to other folks, and it's such a great message because early detection, you can beat this, and you can go on and have an incredible life.
Right, right. And I tell people, don't be afraid.
Mm.
Don't be afraid of a cancer diagnosis. Stay ahead of it. Just like anything else in life, you need to stay one step ahead of it. And also, if I might mention, there's a little bit of confusion out there about what age you should be when you start having your mammograms. And, you know, old school was 40 years old for people to get a mammogram, but now it's a conversation with your doctor. If you have a history of breast cancer in your family, you might start at 25 or 30 years old.
Right.
If you have no history and you've been clear for years, they're saying at 55 years old, then you go every 2 years for a mammogram. So there's no set age. It's a conversation that you need to have starting at a young age with your primary care doctor.
You know, Karla, I really believe this. I mean, you're a real hero, and I know that's not what you're profiling, but you really are. I mean, you know, speaking up, delivering this message, working with this great cancer organization, and I think somebody once said that everybody can make a difference, and one person can make a difference, and everybody should try. You're making a difference every day. You know, getting that message out that, you know, there is another end game to cancer, mm-hmm, and it's very different from what some people think. You can go on and have a wonderful life as you are having, and a wonderful family and having great experiences,
mm-hmm,
but that message is important to get out there. There's no question about it, and you know, you're doing that with the American Cancer Society, and you're doing it with Real Men Wear Pink, which we're very proud to be able to partner with you.
We are so happy to have you, and you know, we've spoke a little bit before coming on camera, and we work hard, we play hard. It's okay to have fun with this.
Yes.
It really is. It's okay to have fun, raise the funds, rally the troops, educate the community, and that's really what it's all about. It's not about me, it's about everyone else out there that this may affect,
yeah,
and we want to get ahead of it so we can help them out as well.
Yeah, but you're a great deliverer of the message.
Thank you.
You know,
appreciate that.
You know, you have to have that message out there, and you're a wonderful, talented person.
Well, I appreciate the opportunity.
And Karla will come on and finish the interview.
Okay, great.
All right.
Thank you.
I am so, so excited to be here this morning with Miss Karla from the American Cancer Society.
Yes.
what is your passion? Why kind of, what are you really, really adamant about? What are you really passionate about? What leads you into this this role that you're doing this year?
Well, because I've been lucky enough to be a survivor myself and my mom of breast cancer, I'm really passionate about the educational piece, about getting the message out there that early detection saves lives. Whether it's breast cancer or any other cancer, it's just really important to stay on top of your health and talk to your doctor and make sure you know what's going on.
So, we're in a new year.
Okay.
A brand new year, and I understand you represent both the American Cancer Society and also Real Men Wear Pink.
That's right.
And we're just so really excited to partner with you this year. We really are. But what is the transition this year? I mean, what are you really excited about? And I know we're joking off camera, and I said, something that you think about at night, the first thing, and you was like, no, that may be the second thing that I think about. But transitioning into the programming this year, so what really excites you moving forward?
Well, I'm really excited about getting some guys that rally around the cause. We see the women all the time, and I really often have people come to me and go, what's all this pink? How come women have the pink? Well, you know what? It's the guys' turn to kind of step up and let these women know that they have a strong supporter in the background. So we have roughly 10 men that are going to represent this campaign in and around the Lucas County area. And I'm excited about seeing all their faces on the website and all of their pink and displaying the pink all of October and just raising awareness and letting this local women and their friends and family know that you're there for them.
And let me add to this, out of those 10 men, Tom and myself were part of that, correct?
Absolutely.
That's great.
Yes, you are. Absolutely. You are. Uh-huh. Yes. And you need to show those shoes off because they're pretty sweet.
Oh, okay, yeah. Hey, I got my pink socks on, too.
Oh, you do?
Real man wear pink, right?
That's right.
Okay, so, hey, you know what, Karla? It's such a fantastic time having you. I am so pleased that Tain Automotive and the American Cancer Society and also Real Men Wear Pink, all of next month, the month of October.
That's right.
Is that correct?
That's right.
So just give our audience some details in regards to how we can get in contact with you, how we can donate, and how we can support.
Okay, so there's several different ways. There's a Real Men Wear Pink of Northwest Ohio Facebook page that people can go to, and there'll be a list there of all the candidates that are participating in this campaign. We also have a link that someone can click on and click on your picture, put in your credit card. They have a goal of $2,500. We will have all of that information. Real Men Wear Pink of Northwest Ohio 2021 can be Googled. You can find it on Facebook, and then also we'll have a link.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? We are so very, very excited.
Yeah, I am too.
Just to let you know, and I'm not shy in admitting this. Actually, I have an Afro pink wig downstairs. That I will be wearing in the next couple of weeks. So
awesome.
I just thought I would share that very important information with you.
Yeah, I'd love it. I didn't know that.
Okay, this has been the Steve Taylor Community Connection Show. See you next time.